Welcome to the Easy Coordinator Quick Start video. In this short video, I'm going to give you a quick overview on how to set up your account so you can start taking advantage of all of the benefits of Easy Coordinator. First, let's go into the admin section. Your first tab is going to be account information. This is where you can change your password as well as enter some information about yourself. Next is where you're going to set up your email alerts. To turn on alerts, just select the box and enter the number of days prior to the due date that you want to receive an email alert. In addition, you can select to receive an alert after the date has expired, and you can turn your task alerts on or off. Next, we have the document library, and this is a central document library where you can store documents that either your agents or other people who are using your account are going to need access to. The first step is to set up a folder, and then you can begin uploading documents into that folder. And this is how it's going to look to the users. There's the folder name, and here is the name of the file. And what I can do is I can select this file, and I can then move it to a transaction. And it will move a copy into that transaction so that the user can now access that document. Next is your status, types, and sale types. So for status and types, you can turn on or off the ones that you do want to see. And for sale types, you have the ability to do some customization. So if I want to customize one of these, I just select the one I want to customize, and I type a new name. And my customization has been set. Next, we have the additional info section. This is where you can set up as many customized fields as you'd like to track additional information on your transactions. So you can set up different categories. You can see that I've got a short sale and an REO category. And in here, I've got different fields that I want to track. To add a new field, you just type in the name, select the type of field, and select the category, and it will be added. Next is the task list area. To set up a new task list, just type the name in here and select whether it's a task list or a document list. If you want to track documents that are required on every single transaction, and you want to be able to review those documents for compliance at the end of the file, then I would use the document list. And we have other videos in our YouTube page which will allow you to see the functionality of how to review documents for compliance. But this is the first step in setting that up. So either select task or document, and then you can add tasks to that new list. And in all premium accounts, you have the ability to set up preset due dates. So if this task is always due 7 days after the contract effective date, I can set that up in here. And now whenever this task list is added to a transaction, the system will automatically set a due date for me for this task. And to have task lists automatically saved to a transaction, just select the checkbox here, and they will automatically be added to a new transaction when you add one. Next is the document folder section, and this is where you can create as many customized folders as you'd like, and these folders will be standard in every single transaction that you have. So you can see in here I've got contracts, listings, and miscellaneous, so I can edit or delete these. In addition, I can add new ones. And last but not least is the DocuSign tab. This is where you're going to enter your DocuSign credentials in order to link your DocuSign account to Easy Coordinator so you can send out documents for signature directly from your Easy Coordinator account. That's the end of Quick Start video number one. Good luck, and if you have any questions using Easy Coordinator, please contact us for any assistance. Thank you.